Hey, what's up, garden friends? Jeff here, Tropical Plant Party.
How's everybody doing?
I hope you're good.
I am great.
Time to move some orchids outside.
Past time. Way overdue, really. Should have done this a couple weeks ago, probably. My Vanda orchids, I like to wait until things are right around mid-40s and up at nighttime. Not as concerned about the daytime temperatures, because it's right now it's like late April, early May. So it's going to be warming up to a point where I know they're safe to take outside. And since a lot of the videos from here and on are going to be more moving all the rest of the tropicals out, I thought I'd go ahead and just do like a quick video, kind of fun vlog style video, moving the Vandas out.
I mean, hopefully it'll be fun. I'm really just moving orchids. It's not too terribly exciting.
Typically, I would give these a soak before moving them, but I'm going to do something with them outside that it's not necessary. I'll show you.
Yeah, see? I'm outside. When I bring them out, I'm giving them a heavy soak anyway, so it just isn't really necessary to give them that soak beforehand. I probably should have sprayed them down or something just to be safe, because that would make the roots less brittle, but it was fine. I was just very, very careful. So this is my outdoor pond. There's no fish in here. The fish get moved out in the springtime. I'm going to have to do something different here because the fish grew a lot, but for now, it's coming in handy for making some fun Vanda soup. Look at that. Got a nice little Vanda hot tub going on in here. The water's green. That's just algae, which is fine. The orchids actually should probably appreciate it. I'm going to give these a very long soak, like probably maybe an hour, something like that. So I'm gonna let these keep soaking, and when they're all done, I'll start building up the Vanda garden. Here's what I'm doing to start working on that Vanda garden. Back here I have all of my trellises. These were just like, I don't know, they were super cheap. I got them on clearance from Home Depot last year, or 2 years ago actually. This one right here, I can see there is some rust on it, but I can't touch that up right now. It's gonna have to wait a little while. The reason I'm moving the Vandas out right now is because it's supposed to rain a lot the next few days, like for 4 days straight. Vandas like a lot of water, temperatures are gonna be cooler, and then it's supposed to warm up. So I think that having that nice drench, all that fun water coming down on them, and then the change in the temperature, I think they're going to appreciate that and hopefully trigger some blooms. So here's what I'm doing. I've got a bunch of stakes over here on the ground, and I'm going to use these to prop these trellises up. The weight of the Vandas last year kind of pulled them back a little bit, so I want to go ahead and just take care of that. I'm just going to stake those down. Nothing too terribly exciting there. All of these little... talking's hard. All these little hanging pans here. I have a whole bunch. There's even... I have more over there too. I use those to kind of fill in the gaps with different annuals, things that just kind of like the heavy watering that the Vandas get and the afternoon shade and whatnot. It's not probably gonna be time to fill those in yet, though I have a few things I can put in there. I usually do like bromeliads and sometimes coleus, stuff like that. It just kind of depends on what I have around. But yes, that's what's going on there. Back here, a large part of this, I like for things to have a function. So these three trellises here aren't just, they're for the Vandas, but it also provides some privacy. I don't like being able to see straight through here. And this house is for sale. I don't know who's moving in there. Maybe they have a lot of dogs, a lot of children, which I love both of those things, but just not like constantly in my face, or in my space, I should say. So I'm gonna go ahead and stake these up and get moving with that. Oh, and I don't want to forget, I also have this Virginia creeper here. I have a few of them, actually. This is the Star Showers Virginia creeper. They're zone 4 through 9. They need a minimum of 3 hours of direct sun a day, and I'm thinking I'm gonna plop one back here on the fence, and just, you know, I'm gonna have to stay on top of it, make sure it doesn't grow up into the trees and go absolutely crazy. It needs to stay looking nice, because I don't know, I'm not sure what the HOA's rules are. I don't think I'm allowed to be planting stuff on the fence, but I'm not really sure either. I'm thinking, you know, just keep it nice and tidy, and hopefully it won't be an issue for anyone, right? There we go. So that was pretty easy, you know, just digging a hole. I went ahead and scored the sides because there's a lot of clay in there. A little bit of the Espoma plant tone in there. The biotone starter would have been probably better, but I'm out of that, and the plant tone will work just fine. And I backfilled this with a gardening compost that I mixed with some like old potting soil. Just because, it's solid clay. So that's why I scored the sides when I dug the hole, so that those things can kind of work themselves together and not end up forming like a hard pot in the ground that holds on to water. Easy. And I like the variegation. The variegation helps light things up in the shade. It kind of draws the eyes back into the dark, and that's perfect. That's what I need back here.
And I realize that's not perfectly straight, but, y'all know what I say to that. Yeah, I'll get it off that stake and wire it onto the fence there pretty soon.
Hey, it's been about an hour and I've got everything hung up here. Well, mostly everything hung up. I went ahead, I got the Vandas hung up. There's still a few that are soaking that I think need a little bit longer. You can see, even after an hour of soaking, Within about 10 minutes, these roots are already turning white and dry.
That's why I like to move these out when there's a lot of rain in the forecast,
because the humidity just doesn't really kick in here where I live. I'm in St. Louis, zone 6A, 6B. Doesn't get that, like, muggy outside until about, like, mid-May, sometimes early May. And that's what these guys like. It helps keep their roots wet a lot longer.
In years past, I have waited until much later in May to bring them out when things were nice and warm. I decided that it would be smart this year to go ahead and bring them out when there's still some stuff changing with the weather, when there's still going to be, like, a drastic night and daytime temperature shift. I think that'll help encourage them to bloom. I mean, hopefully, that's the idea here anyways. I did go through and I started tucking in some bromeliads. These are the Tillandsia cyanes. Putting those in those little pots and hanging them up. I just like to have the little pops of color, the extra texture. I also have this tray here full of other plants that should go well with the Vandas, ferns, more of those Tillandsias. What is over here? This is a Sinungium podophyllum. Just a lot of plants that will also like the heavy amount of water that's going to be over here. And still with the ferns, I'm going to have to be wary and be careful because they could get crown rot. I have to water these orchids anywhere from 2 to 3 times a day, depending on the humidity.
I like incorporating the other plants, the ferns and whatnot. I just think it adds a nice extra texture. It kind of breaks down just kind of having the wall of green and roots, which I love, but it does help fill things in quite a bit. So putting these rabbit's foot ferns in here, those are going to airplane.
And here are the leftovers. These are the things that didn't fit and have space for, which is fine. These two have, they're done blooming actually, and they're starting to put out pups, so they need to be repotted anyways. So that's okay, works out just fine like that.
I did decide to not go ahead and put those stakes in because I still need to pull these out and paint them, which I'll be doing when the forecast is clear. It's supposed to start raining here any minute now, and it's supposed to stay that way for a few days, which is ideal for bringing the Vandas out, but not for painting things. Also, the wooden stakes, the roots of the Vandas, they're going to grab right onto those, so I should use something plastic to help hold those up. So I'm not going to, that wasn't a good idea. Glad I thought about that one for a minute before I went ahead and put those in there.
So that's it. That's pretty much all there is to it. Nothing crazy, nothing super elaborate, not right now anyways.
I was happy to finally get my wind chime hung up. I think that'll be nice over there.
And then this Platycerum fern over here, this Microsorum punctatum, but that was in one of the Fern Fridays. I'm gonna do something else with that eventually, but for now I just wanted to get outside. I think that's a good spot for it. Oh, and all of these little metal holders here, I don't remember where I got them from. I know they sell them at Garden, that's not Garden Ridge anymore, at Home, and I've seen them on Amazon, and I do drill holes in the bottom of them, actually at the angle where they hang down. I make sure there's holes so water can get through them. And I'm sure that they would look a lot better and not fade so much if, you know, maybe were to bring them inside during the winter time and not leave them outside to the elements.
Whoops. I can repaint them. That's not a big deal. This thing over here, I'm not sure if I'm going to keep that. I'm kind of over it. It was a gift and it just doesn't look right. I need to put a new pot in it. I don't know. I may end up just trying to grab another one of these trellises here and putting that in its place so I can spread them out a little bit further. I did make sure that the Vandas were up higher. Like, there's nothing down low, and that's because the morning sun, very strong period. But the way that morning sun's coming through, it's lighting things from the bottom for a lot longer than the top. So you need to, you know, acclimate them. They can't just throw them right into the sun. That's too much for them. So I will need to be keeping an eye on things. I may have to move some things around, but for the next few days, shouldn't be an issue. It's getting cloudy, and I think it's going to stay that way for a little while.
I have noticed that when it comes to companion planting with these ferns, with the Vandas, the bromeliads always seem to do the best. Like I said, I'm going to have to keep an eye on the ferns, a very, very, very watchful eye on them to make sure they don't start to rot or anything like that from having the water on them in the centers of them all of the time. They will likely be swapped out fairly soon with other bromeliads. I like to hit up Walmart this time of year or the next couple weeks. It's late April, early May, which I think I already said.
Because at least where I live, they tend to get them in when it's kind of cold out and put them outside, and then they sort of go downhill, and then they clearance them out for really cheap, and then you stick them outside, and then, you know, you give them a little bit of TLC and they look great, and they fill in the gaps really well, and they like that water. They like a similar light, not all bromeliads, just like the Brisias and the really common ones you see. They don't like as much light, so they have to go up higher, but they seem to do well with the moisture. That's the main thing.
I never have been able to put other orchids with the Vandas. They're a unique orchid. Lots and lots of water, lot of light compared to a lot of the other orchids. It just doesn't work out well mixing with other orchids. But the bromeliads and the ferns and whatnot, those always seem to do fairly well. And coleus I put in here, that looks good too. It's just to fill in the gaps. I just kind of like having this like jungle wall back here, and it adds some privacy. And I'm liking this vine on the fence a lot. Look at how much that illuminates, which is, I mean, I don't necessarily want the eye drawn back there really, but that's going to be more green as those leaves mature. This just flushed out with its spring growth, so it's not going to be, it's not, the variegation's not going to be that intense. It's not going to stay that way.
And yes, there's a broken pot up there. I haven't decided what to do with it yet. I might end up like incorporating it and planting things around it to give it sort of like a ruins appearance.
I don't know how much that's going to matter though, because this whole area here in the next few weeks is going to have quite the glow up. This is just sort of like my storage area for this time of year, but in a few weeks I'll have a very large adenidia palm in the middle and other things going on in these two pots, and you really won't even be able to see back there all that well. It's gonna be one of those things where you have to know to go back there and look at it and appreciate it, which I like.
And it will help cast a little bit more shade if things are too sunny, but if they're too sunny, I gotta move them right away, so hopefully that's not gonna be a problem.
I actually just remembered I need to go hit up Walmart like right now, because I only have like 3 hours left to do a week's worth of yard work for this weekend's vlog. So I'll be hitting up Walmart, Lowe's. If I see anything fun on clearance, I'll throw that in there, and that'll all be in the vlog that comes out after this video. It's probably one or two videos from now. This is just gonna keep on growing. This is kind of like a rough draft, I guess you could say. Just needed to get them out and get them hung up. I do so want to paint those arbors. Having a fresh coat of paint on them too makes them less porous and the roots are less likely to stick to them, because just about every single year a couple of the Vandas grab onto them in the spots where the paint starts to wear off, so I will be like, regardless of the rust, they're going to be repainted anyways. Then I have to tear up the roots when I bring them back inside in the winter time, like late fall, and I don't want to have to do that. It's a setback. It's enough having that big transition, that big transformation with the weather. Oh, and look at, you see that? That's how strong the sun's been. It's only like maybe 3 hours of morning sun over here. Look at what happened to her. She'll be all right though. Everything's okay. Well, I hope everybody's doing well. Maybe it seems a little bit random. I don't do orchid videos that often, and this isn't really an orchid video, more of just a vlog, me setting up my little Vanda screen, my Vanda wall, my epiphytic ferny, I don't know. Whatever you would call this, that's what it is. It's a privacy screen, and I know it's sloppy right now, but that's just, I just needed to get them out here. I have to take this all apart in like a week, hopefully when I can get a couple days without rain, to go ahead and paint these guys. But I thought it'd be fun to bring y'all along for the process.
Just the beginning. Things are just getting started out here. I'm so happy. It's so nice outside.
At least for like the next couple of hours. I need to move on. I gotta go. I'm sorry, guys. I gotta get things done out here.
As always, hope everybody's doing well, having a great day, great life. Everything's just going fantastic for you. Hey, and don't forget to leave the video a thumbs up. It helps the channel a lot, and I do appreciate it. And subscribe as well, and hit that notification bell, because I upload multiple times a week. That way, you know new videos come out. I have my social media linked down below in the description. Follow me, and I'll follow you back. I'm on Instagram far more than anything else. And of course, as always, and most importantly, everybody, keep on growing. Bye bye. Bye.